Do you like puzzles? Games? Things that make your mind go brrrr? In that case, you should like word problems in algebra, but maybe you don't. Maybe, in fact, you hate word problems because you always get the wrong answer. Let me tell you a secret. It's all about vocabulary. It's right there in the name. Word problems require you to understand words. Not just any words, math words. This video is an introduction to decoding the words in word problems. But if you want to really get into it, I wrote a little book for you, How to Solve Word Problems. It teaches you the 8 key skills involved in solving word problems. Understanding what math words mean is one of those 8 skills. Find the link below to get your copy. Now, let's explore some common terms and phrases from word problems. We'll learn how to translate them into math language. You'll recognize math language because instead of words, it uses numbers, letters for variables, and symbols like these. Less than and greater than. Less than has its own special symbol. Less than means one thing is smaller than another. For example, Joey has fewer than 5 sandwiches. We don't know how many sandwiches Joey has, so we give it a variable name, S. We do know that the number of sandwiches is less than 5, so we can write it as S is less than 5. Greater than is the opposite of less than, and its symbol faces the other direction. Greater than means one thing is larger than another, or there's more of that thing than something else. Pippi has more than 50 freckles. That's pretty lucky. We give the number of freckles a variable name, because we don't know how many freckles exactly. Let's call this number F. We can then translate from words into math language, like this. F is greater than 50. You may have realized already that there are a lot of synonyms for math words. Larger than, greater than, more than, bigger than. They all mean the same thing. Be on the lookout for families of words like this. Increased by and decreased by. The plus sign and minus signs are used a lot in math language. Here are 2 situations where you will use these math symbols. If you say something increases by a certain amount, you use addition, or the plus symbol. For example, we can say that the number of owls in your neighborhood has increased by 6. Let's pick a variable name for the number of owls. Can you see why we probably shouldn't use the letter O? O looks a lot like the number 0, so to avoid confusion, let's use the letter W. You can pick any letter you like when you're doing word problems. After all, you know the solution to avoiding variable name confusion. Just pick a different letter. Once we choose our variable name, we can write out the math language translation, W plus 6. Similarly, we can express the opposite idea with the minus sign to show that a value has decreased by a certain amount. This is subtraction. If the word problem says the number of mice has decreased by 20, we can write it like this, M for the number of mice, M minus 20. Sum of and product of. Another way you will use the plus symbol is when you see the word sum or total. The sum of numbers is their total when added together. For example, the sum of the boys and girls in class is 24. Right now, we don't know how many boys, so let's call that variable B, and the number of girls is another unknown, so let's call that G. But we do know that the sum of the two numbers is 24, so we can write that as B plus G equals 24. The product of two numbers is another way to say you should multiply those two numbers together. We use the multiplication sign to stand for that idea. For example, the product of the length of the window and the height of the window is the area. L times H equals A. Do you know why we wrote a capital L instead of a lowercase l? Because the lowercase l looks like the number 1, so it's not a great letter to use for a variable name. You can, if you really want to, but why make things harder than they have to be, you know? Percent of. Did you know that percent means per 100? For example, if we read in a word problem that Jeff bought tangerines for 20% off, that means the discount was 20 out of 100, or 20 over 100. For every 100 pennies of the price, 20 of them are subtracted from the price. If the price is T, the discount is 20 over 100 times T, or 0.2 times T. This kind of work you have to do, translating words into math language, is one of the reasons why word problems are harder than the regular problems you see in your math textbook. The more you practice, the better you'll get at recognizing and using these mathematical cues to solve a wide range of real-world problems. If you want to hashtag learn more about how to solve word problems, remember, you can pick up a copy of my book, How to Solve Word Problems. You can also subscribe to Socratica High. Why don't you do both?